Good morning. My name is Kannan Moudgalya. I am from IIT Bombay. I am the coordinator of the project Teaching Learning Center ICT, funded by the Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission on Teachers and Teaching. I welcome you all to this workshop. Along with me is Professor Prabhu Ramachandran, who is one of the driving forces behind the FOSSI project. He also leads the Python effort for the country. So this is what I mentioned. Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya National Mission on Teachers and Teaching is happy to bring this workshop to all of you. And special thanks are to NME ICT, which is the National Mission on Education through ICT, an initiative of MHRD. The first entity here is T10KT, or Train 10,000 Teachers. All the 187 remote centers where you are all attending this workshop were established under T10KT by Professor Fatak. And then I already mentioned about FOSSI, free and open source software for education. Spoken tutorial, you will use spoken tutorial today. I will say a few more words after that. We are connecting with you through the software AVIEW, created by Amrita University, with a large amount of funding coming from NME ICT. This is the schedule for the workshop, today's workshop. Our program will be till about 10:30, then we will have a break, and then you will learn Python using spoken tutorials. At 12:30, for about half an hour, we will meet again for a brief interaction. Then 1 to 2 is the lunchtime. Then you will continue to learn Python using spoken tutorials with a coffee break thrown in. Finally, we will meet again at 5 o'clock for final interaction and also any questions you might have. In this, we will mainly talk about how this workshop will be conducted. Why Python? This is the work I had asked you to do. We sent these slides yesterday. Listen to this 8-minute video on Python. I hope most of you would have listened to it. We have said that watching these videos, well, actually there are more videos that are coming later, is a prerequisite for this workshop. So we actually have Professor Prabhu Ramachandran with us. He is the one who delivered this 8-minute video. He has promised to condense the same thing and explain the same thing in about, you know, a few minutes, less than 5 minutes. I am going to hand over the mic to Professor Prabhu Ramachandran. Should I give this?
Good morning, everyone. So thank you for joining us today. I'll try to keep this brief. I'm really happy to be doing this workshop, thanks to the effort and initiative of Professor Kannan and the Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya project national mission that we have. What I'll try to do now is quickly summarize the video that I've shared with you earlier. I'd like to do a quick poll first to find out how many of you have actually watched this video. Can you please answer the poll that's available and let us know if you have actually seen this video or not. So there's a poll that's live now. The question is, have you seen the video that has been circulated on Python? You need to answer yes or no. I'd just like to get some sense of how many people have seen this. All right, so thank you so much for answering this poll. So most of you seem to have seen this video, and so I won't bore you with the same thing again. What I'll do is I'll quickly summarize what we've discussed in that video. So the first thing I'd like to mention is that this whole initiative has essentially been funded through the FOSSI project. All the material, the content that was generated was through the FOSSI project, which is funded by MHRD. And the goal of this project is to essentially increase the use of FOSS in education and to minimize the use of commercial software in education. So this is an extremely important initiative, and we are grateful to the government for supporting this. So getting on to Python itself, if you recall, I had mentioned these specific points in the video. The issue that we have is, it's not always that we just need to do simple numeric and symbolic computing with any kind of toolkit. So it's not enough if you have a system like say MATLAB or some other commercial tool. We also need to do exploration and visualization. Very often we need to do high performance computing. We also sometimes need to do parallel computing. We may need to build user interfaces or build a website. And nowadays you can see there's a huge amount of effort that's spent in trying to do data analysis as well as machine learning. In addition to these, there are other tasks, sometimes routine system administration tasks, automation tasks that one needs to do when you're using Python. So all of these need to be done by a scientist or an engineer, especially when you're using a computer. And so what we're trying to say is Python is a very good choice for doing this. The reason is it's easy to read and learn. It has a powerful interactive interpreter which allows you to do interactive visualization and exploration. It's scalable and general purpose. So it's not just a specific language that's designed for say engineering computation. It's a general purpose language, which means it's also high level and modular, which means you can, with a few lines of code, you can actually do a lot of things. It's also modular, which means you can compose it with nice, small, well-written pieces of code. And it also supports, in terms of computer science, it supports procedural, object-oriented, and functional approaches. And it doesn't force any of these down your throat. So it's a very powerful, encouraging language that allows you to do a lot of things. In addition to this, it also has extensive libraries. And this is probably one of the biggest reasons why Python is popular today. All of this facilitates rapid application development. And more importantly, it's cross-platform, which means it runs on all common operating systems, and it's completely open source, which means there are no licensing restrictions. So what we're trying to say is that there are many diverse needs, and there's this one language, Python, that if you learn, you're able to accomplish all of these things. And that's the reason we're trying to teach you Python. So what I'll quickly do is show you a small demonstration of a tool called Jupyter Notebooks, which are very popular, but it's come out of, again, the Python community. Although Jupyter Notebooks can be used from other programming languages as well, this is a screenshot of a Jupyter Notebook, which essentially is a web-based interface. In fact, my entire presentation is also made on a Jupyter Notebook. And what you can do is you can mix mathematics, text, code, and the output of that code in the same notebook, and you can share it online, which is a very important thing for scientists, especially in this age of data analysis. So what I'm going to do is actually show you a Jupyter notebook with a simple demo where I'm going to record some sound and immediately plot the spectrogram. So I just have some few imports. Many of these imports you're already going to see during these spoken tutorials. In fact, there's only one import here that you're not going to be familiar with, but that's all right. So I'm going to run that. So now you can see that in my live presentation, I'm able to run this code. And now I'm going to quickly record something. So maybe I'm going to record for about 2 seconds. So maybe, shall I request you to say something? Hello.
Good morning, Python participants. Okay. This is the first step to artificial intelligence.
Okay, so it only recorded 2 seconds. So it only did 2 seconds. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to plot a spectrogram immediately of this actual raw data. And so it looks a little small here, but you can see that I've interactively looked at the sound that Professor Kannan generated, and then actually plotted a spectrogram. I think I can also play back what was recorded.
Good morning.
Okay, so it was just good morning. So Kannan's good morning was recorded. So the idea what I wanted to show you is it's an extremely powerful, rich, interactive environment that demonstrates to you a lot of power and functionality that's available at your fingertips. And that's the reason why we feel Python is so important. Now, I'll just wrap up with a few overall comments, again leading to our own workshop series. One of the important things that we've seen in this day and age is that there's a lot of data, and we all need to do data analysis. In the Python world, there are many useful data analysis libraries, and some of these you will actually learn during this workshop, but not all of them. In particular, you'll be learning about NumPy, Matplotlib, a little bit about SciPy maybe. But there's also other powerful libraries like Pandas, Jupyter, and if you want to do statistical work, there's a package called Stats Model that lets you do simple statistical models, generalized linear models. And if you want to do Bayesian analysis, there's actually an extremely powerful tool called PyMC3 or PyMC4, which essentially allows you to do Bayesian analysis with Python, and it's extremely easy to use and it's extremely powerful. So these are a sampling of some of the data analysis libraries that are available in the Python universe. And our hope is that once you do this workshop, you will actually be able to either self-teach or there'll be subsequent workshops that will kind of try to teach some of these things for participants who successfully finish this workshop. In addition, as you all are aware, there's a lot of buzz about machine learning, and many of the top most popular machine learning libraries are actually Python libraries or at least have extremely strong Python interfaces. For example, you must have all heard of scikit-learn or Google's TensorFlow or Keras or say PyTorch. All of these are machine learning libraries that are available that can be used directly with Python. So this is one reason again why Python is so important, because it's actually relevant today. So in this workshop, what we'll do is we'll introduce you to basic Python, getting started with Python and IPython. And then we'll show you how to use NumPy and Matplotlib, which are at some level the basic backbone for all of the work that you'll ever do with Python. So with any data analysis, any machine learning, it's always ending up with say NumPy arrays or using Matplotlib or some advanced plotting libraries, but we will focus on the gold standard, which is Matplotlib, which has been around for many, many years. And we'll do this by you self-learning with spoken tutorial. And this has two important reasons. The first is the material is recorded with high quality, as in the content has been created in a fashion that makes it easy to understand. The second thing is it also gives you confidence that you can learn this material by yourself. So if there's good material that's made available to you, you're in a position to teach yourself, along with some help from us, of course. And we will continue to do these things as we go forward. We will provide you some support during the workshop online. There's also a forum support, and I think Professor Kannan will talk about this in greater detail. We'll also have some time for Q&A, so you can ask your questions to us, either on the forum or live in person, and then we'll try our best to answer those questions. In addition to this, there's also other free learning material that FOSSI makes available. The first is self-learning with spoken tutorials that's available that you're going to be using through this course. There are also some remote workshops we conduct for Python through FOSSI, and there's also an online self-learning course that's also available. But what's important is we also have additional material. And if you do well in this workshop, we will be covering later intermediate aspects and more advanced Python as well, using the same kind of mechanism, perhaps with slightly more interactivity for those participants who do successfully in this program. So we would like you to please pay attention and make sure you complete this successfully. We will have a test that examines how well you have understood this material, using which we will accept you for the next round of training. So if you have more questions, you can always contact us, and I will hand it back to Professor Kannan. Thank you, and looking forward to hearing from you soon.
Hello again. How will this workshop be conducted? As Professor Prabhu already mentioned, using spoken tutorial and video conference, based interaction through AVU, through 187 remote centers. Is this workshop method effective? Nobody is going to teach. You may want to listen to this TED talk that I gave on spoken tutorial. We had sent this slide earlier. It may not have much relevance now. It was supposed to have been done before the workshop. What is important in this is that you have to register here so that you can ask questions on the spoken tutorial forum. And I had also asked you to listen to a brief part of this video which explains how to use the forum. I hope that most of you would have gone through this video. It's just less than 2 minutes. We would request you to post your questions whenever you have a problem. Supposing you say that you have a question in plotting at 3 minutes 22 seconds. So then you will say that you will choose Python as the topic, then plotting as the title of the video, then you will say that it is between 3 and 4 minutes, then 20 and 30 seconds, and then you will ask your question. If somebody has already asked the question, you would also see the answer. We want to thank you for paying rupees 500. From the industry participants, we are collecting 1000 rupees. As I mentioned already, a large number of people are attending this, actually 5012 participants, mostly faculty members, and we are very happy that many school teachers, lecturers, heads of departments, deans, vice principals and so on are attending this workshop. This is happening in 24 states and union territories in 187 remote centers. We had also asked you to bring a pair of we also asked you to bring a pair of earphones, because without them the workshop will not be effective. All of you will have to listen to videos and practice, and if you have 30 laptops making this sound, then it will be very noisy. So we would request all of you to use the earphone and listen to the tutorials through your earphone. Okay. You will use the side by side learning method. On half the screen you will open the video, in this case the spoken tutorial. On the other side you will open Python, whether it is IPython notebook or Jupyter, whatever it is. You will have access to Python here, and then whatever the video says you have to reproduce here. This is what you have to do. Remember, in this method you should not maximize, because maximize means this alone will take up the whole space. If you have difficulty, ask somebody how to change the screen size, window size, so that you can make it about half the size. Your neighbor will be able to help you with that in case you have difficulty in doing this. And I had also asked you to go through this 5 minutes of this video, which explains the side by side learning method. The reason for doing this side by side method is that it reduces the cognitive overload. For example, of course you can always keep two full screens and you can keep switching, but psychologists believe that that increases the cognitive overload. That is why we are recommending the side by side method. Your remote center will provide computers for the workshop. They are already ready with this. If you have brought your laptop, of course you can use them. How many tutorials to learn from? If you are a beginner, practice the first 21 tutorials. If you know more, I am sure there are many experts amongst you, so they can learn all the videos. And if there are people who say that, hey, I practiced all of these, what do I do? Please help others by answering questions on the forum and also answering the doubts that your colleagues in the remote center may have. There are also some people who may not be able to complete all 21 tutorials. Don't worry about it. You can copy all the tutorials into your pen drive and learn at your convenience. The test that Professor Prabhu pointed out would happen from amongst the tutorials. The exact portion will be announced later, and there will be enough time for you to learn all of them, even if you can't complete all of them today. What are the takeaways from the workshop? In this workshop, we are not going to teach anything. You are going to learn everything from spoken tutorials. Because we are not teaching, but you will learn, the same method can be adopted by you in your colleges and schools for your colleagues and also students. So, if you have any questions, please ask our e-outreach team or call this number. Thank you for joining. I would also like to introduce our team. Any of the team members outside? Can you just show the camera point to that? Give the mic. Let them say a few words what they are doing.
And I'm from the spoken tutorial content creation team.
Good morning, all. I am Usha. I am from the FOSI team.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Mahendra Parmar, and I am from workshop team. So, I just want to make one announcement. We have opened the on-the-spot registration. Just in case if you have a sitting capacity, and participants who have not registered come to your center, please allow them to do the online registration. And the participants should make sure that they pay the course fee online. That's it from my side. And request registered, if you have made the payment online and your registration status has not changed, please do not worry. Please share the transaction details with us. We'll take care of it from our end. Thanks.
Good morning. My name is Sajan Dixit, and I am from studio team.
Good morning, I'm Vinita and I'm from the FOSI team.
Hello everyone, my name is Tushar.
Thank you. Thank you team. I hope the participants would have heard of some of our team members. Some of them would have sent emails to you, phoned you or answered your phone calls, and so on. So, what we will do now is, we will spend about maybe 15 to 20 minutes to answer your questions, not on Python. I don't want you to ask questions on, can Python be used in engineering, can be used in schools, and so on and so forth. Please do not ask those questions. Those questions can be reserved for either 12:30 session or at 5 o'clock session. I want you to ask questions regarding the conduct of the workshop. If you have something not clear, how is this workshop conducted? If you think, look, I don't know how I can learn this material, I am sitting in let's say Jharsuguda, and then I want to learn, and you call it IIT Bombay workshop, but I don't see any IIT Bombay people here. Or how can I, what do I do if I get stuck? What if nobody can answer my question? Things like that, please do ask those questions now, so that we understand exactly how to conduct the workshop, how to learn from this workshop, so that nobody has a problem. You can all get started. The moment you do that, you can ask your questions through the forum and so on. So, we will come to that. So, if there are any questions from remote centers, we will be happy to answer.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
We are from RC1400 Women's Polytechnic College, Pondicherry.
Yeah, please go ahead.
This is related, you have just posted the PDF, sir. In that PDF, you have mentioned a video how to post the questions in the spoken tutorial forum. if you could just give the option of downloading this PDF so that it would be easy for us to give it to the participants so that they can watch that video how to post the questions in the forum, sir. All the participants have registered in the spoken tutorial, but we have the issues how to post the questions in the forum. You have just mentioned a 5 minutes video.
Yes.
So just make this PDF to be downloadable format so that we can just use that link for the participants to post the questions, sir.
Okay.
This is from our side, sir.
Okay, thank you. It's a good question because it allows me to explain something that I forgot to explain. To ask questions on the forum or to see the questions being answered live, you need the internet connection. You need the internet connection, but thankfully you can use the 4G in your phone itself to ask questions. We don't recommend 4G for listening to the videos. Videos have been given to you, but to ask questions on the forum. Okay, let me just show you where the forum is in case just connect the I need the keyboard. That's enough. So you have to go to spoken-tutorial.org and then you have a link called forums. Now, if you want to just see questions, previous questions answered, it's all here. For example, if you select Python, you will have all the questions of Python coming here. Large number of questions have been already asked and answered. If you want to ask a question on, let's say, this multiple plots, if you click here, then you will see all the questions asked on multiple plots. There is only one question that has been asked. So as a result, let me go back. So for example, loading data from files. If you ask this, then all the questions that were already asked and answered will appear in chronological fashion. For example, this happens at first minute, then second minute, this happens at third minute, and so on. So you can actually go and see this, what was the question and what was answered and things like that, right. So in order to do this, you need internet. In order to access this, you need internet. To watch it, you don't need to log in. Notice that I have not logged in, but if you want to ask a question, then it will ask for login. This is to prevent the spam that we have created this. You have to log in. And then it will allow you to ask questions. That is the reason why we said register in our website, spoken tutorial website, and ask questions. Okay, let's go to the next. If there are any other questions, we'll go there. Yeah, Prist University, Tanjavur.
Okay. Everybody here, sir?
We can hear you. Please go ahead.
Okay. Actually, we have 35 slots are there. Only 25 people are there. Some of them have registered and some of them have not paid and some of them did not come. Some they want to join now. What can you do about it? Can you please suggest us?
So, as Mahindra just announced, whoever registered but didn't show up, we can't do anything. We cannot go to their house and bring them here. But on the other hand, if somebody new has come, please allow them to register. Please allow them to register online. Ask them to start learning. Okay, maybe during the break they can register online, and please permit them. Thank you.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Yanamani College, Namakkal. So we'll go to another center.
Hello.
Yeah.
Hello. Birla. Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Anand, Gujarat.
Sir, I'm Rudang Mehta from Dharamsi Desai University, Nadiad, and I'm attending this workshop at BVM College right now in Vidyanagar. I have two questions to ask.
Yeah, please go ahead.
Hello.
We can hear you.
First question is regarding conducting this workshop at our institution for our faculty members, whether it is possible to conduct this workshop again at our institution with remote interaction with you. Is it possible?
This remote, setting up remote interaction and doing this takes a lot of effort. We will repeat it after a few months. It's not possible for us to do this every now and then, but we welcome you to become a remote center.
Okay.
Of ours. Okay. And cater to.
We are already remote center.
So you could have organized it in your remote center now. We sent invitations to all the remote centers to come on board. And we are thankful to all the people who could join. And for those people who could not join, please join next time we announce this. Python seems to be very popular. We might do it again after a few months. At that time, we will request you to join.
Okay, thank you, sir. And second question is regarding the content. Recently, I have attended one IBM seminar on AI and machine learning. And what I found from them is that they are offering courses on AI machine learning and where they are saying that the specific skill set is required for industry, which they think that academic people are not providing. So if we teach this course to our students through spoken tutorial Python, whether it is meeting the industry standard or it is sufficient for industry, I want some comment from you on this.
Yeah, good question. The plan we have is the course that you are talking about, done by IBM or whoever it is, typically will have a very small number of participants. Maybe 25 people, maybe 30 people, things like that. Here, what we want to do is to prepare a large part of our population. For example, I mentioned that 5,000 teachers are attending this workshop. Now, if each teacher can influence 100 students, we are talking about 5 lakh students being benefited by something like this. Okay? So, Python is the first step. Python is a tool using which you can do lots of calculations. You still need the logic, you know, what is meant by machine learning, AI and things like that. The way we plan to address that issue is to conduct another workshop on AI machine learning. That will be a live workshop, once again through the same method, T10KT approach. People who are doing well in this course, who will do well in this course, for example, Professor Prabhu mentioned that for people who do well in this course, there will be advanced Python workshops. So we will conduct a test. Only people who do well in those tests will be invited to attend those workshops. And the same people will be invited also to attend a workshop on AI machine learning. That will also be a one-day thing. That will also be, of course, an introductory workshop. We cannot teach all complex issues of AI machine learning in one day. But it will be a reasonably good introduction, and whoever does well in that course also will find themselves to be lot better suited to attend advanced workshops, whether it is going to be conducted by IBM for computer professionals or let us say General Motors for automobile experts, or some communication engineers and so on and so forth. How does one bring, or even education, how does one bring in AI in these areas? What we are saying is we will provide a good grounding to a large number of people using our method and empowering them in that manner, empowering all of you to go to the next level if you prefer. Because the point is, it is not clear who is interested. A person who scores high mark in your class may not be the most brilliant person. There may be somebody who is scoring only 50-60% marks in your class, but who is extremely motivated, let us say in AI, extremely motivated in Python or in R. We are going to conduct a workshop on R also, which can also be used for machine learning AI. So, the idea is to throw this net wide open and make it available to lots of people and empower them and encourage them to prove themselves that they are really interested in doing something and giving them an opportunity to come up. Okay? Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah. IPS Academy, Indore. If there are school teachers, I would like to hear from them also. Yeah.
Good morning, sir. I am Poonam Sharma from IPS Eastern Campus. I just have a simple question that what are the special features of Python that making it so popular?
So, we will answer this later, because this is something that if you had seen Professor Prabhu Ramachandran's video, he already answered. He already gave a demo. Now, the interaction is mainly to talk about how to conduct the workshop. So, if you have any other question or if there are school teachers in your, so there is somebody behind you who wants to ask a question, please pass the mic.
Hello.
Please go ahead.
Hello. Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Sir, Nitin Multani, this side. I am especially a computer teacher for grade 9 to 12 students of a school. And ma'am, one of the main question is that we are teaching like integrating Python in the CBSE curriculum nowadays, but why we are not focusing on some other new technologies which are coming in the field of IT?
Yeah, good question. So, let's first do Python, because Python is the easiest language to learn. It doesn't have, you don't have to worry about typing, variables, storage allocation, and it enforces discipline. It's very easy to express with a few number of lines. Maybe this answers some of the previous question also. So, that is why Python is very popular. So, let's first implement that, learn that, then we can think about what other technology to implement. So, I am also happy that that you have come from school. You want to say something to the school teachers?
So just as a to build on what Professor Kannan was saying, as you already face your learning Python for and teaching Python to your students, what we are planning to do is for the 11th and 12th syllabus, we are trying to put together some sort of a course that covers all of the essential topics that you would need in terms of Python knowledge. Obviously, we are not going to stick to the way you may perhaps teach it. The idea is to give you the essential knowledge that you need to know with Python in order to be able to teach that content to your own students. And we are trying to do this soon so that maybe in a few months' time, we will be able to offer a course that is specifically targeted to school teachers so that you are able to, you know, teach this new Python to a lot of students. And we can answer your, you know, Python specific queries, as Professor Kannan said, either at 12:30 or at 5 o'clock, I'd be happy to answer any of your Python general questions.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Solapur? Yeah, SK.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah, good morning.
Good morning, sir.
Please go ahead. We can hear you very well.
Sir, good morning. It is a great pleasure that once again IIT has organized such a good workshop on Python. Sir, can we have in a day at least some demonstration on machine learning libraries? At so least
that will happen later. Excuse me, that is going to happen. Maybe next is going to be a workshop in R in this series. Of course, some more advanced Python workshops, and then we are going to do a workshop on AI machine learning. There we will attend to that.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you. Let's go to the next one. So maybe we can have some. Is Nancy here? You want to give a demo of any of those? Okay. So because we have a large number of people who are going through this T10 KT mode first time, I know for sure that most of the school teachers are going through this the first time. We thought it will be useful actually to give a few minutes of demonstration of both side by side method and using the forum. So I am going to request the head of the spoken tutorial content team, Mrs. Nancy Varkey, to take over. After she finishes, we can break for coffee tea, and then we will see you again at 12:30. Thank you. So over to Nancy.